The White House today issuing a statement about the economy, saying we need to reduce spending, but still focusing on investments. So we found that odd because it's kind of tough to do both. So we checked the dictionary to make sure that we understood what each word means. Reduce means to bring down. Investment means to ramp up spending. So, Jonathan, how can they do both?
Well, Charles, this is, I don't know if I'd say Orwellian doublespeak. It's certainly Obamian doublespeak at the highest regard. Nice. But, you know, spending is out now. Stimulus is out. But who's against investment, right? Who's against job creation? These are the buzzwords that the White House now uses to justify more confiscation from people's private earnings, more forced support of companies like General Motors at a 52-week low this past week, or more intervention in what the president always talks about liking, which is a private free market.
Well, Todd, you're a Wall Street guy. Does calling it an investment make it a little sexier for you and maybe something you want to get behind?
Well, if I actually believed it was an investment, I'd be all for it. But it's not. It's just government spending. And, you know, we've been trying it for two years now. Government spending, we've spent up, you know, $700 billion. And where are we at? Stagflation, low growth. Increasing inflation, higher gasoline costs, higher food costs. Maybe we should try the exact opposite, Mr. President. Maybe we should have less investment and less spending.
Well, what do you think? I mean, listen, we know that we had the stimulus and it didn't produce what we thought it would produce, at least what we were told it would produce. So isn't this the same thing, but just with a different name?
No. I mean, so first of all, let's be clear. Republicans are using the word investment when they're really just talking about giving more money to the rich. And what the president's trying to signal is, look, we have an economy where 400 people, control more wealth than 150 million Americans combined.
Can I make the point
now,
that
wait a second. Let me finish. The point
correct.
That actually is correct.
Yeah.
And the point is, are we just going to bring the economy back up to where it was before, where there was a lot of inequality and lack of opportunity?
I'll tell you what.
Are we going to make it work for everyone? The entrepreneurs of the future are the struggling middle-class workers today.
Okay.
Well, you're factually inaccurate, because when the president makes investments, he takes money from people who earns it and gives it to people who doesn't. When the rich, who I know you love to downbeat at every opportunity, when they make money, they actually earn it. It's not given to them through a stimulus or a subsidy or a government investment. They earn it on the free market, and that's the distinction that you don't acknowledge at all.
That's not true at all. I'm saying that, look, to those who are given much, much is expected, and the reason that they're able to earn that money in this country and not, for instance, in Libya is because of the environment that we have created through
our government
that is friendly
stimulus?
To right. their businesses. But they have a responsibility to pass that on to
people that
next
are making
generation.
A lot Let of money.
In. Todd. Hey,
Sally, people that are making a lot of money and income are paying their fair share of taxes. The top 1% of income earners are paying over 30% of the share of all income tax receipts. So to say that the rich aren't paying their fair share is crazy. It's one. Two, you're saying that we give a tax cut to the rich, we're giving them money. No, that's untrue. We're not giving them any money. We're just letting them keep some of their money to save,
what
invest,
they've actually earned.
And spend.
Taxes for the rich are at their lowest rate
but
ever
one thing,
in this country.
But Sally, is it smart though?
No, that's untrue, Sally. That's not true.
Associated Press said that the rich this year paid 17%.
I don't care what some journalist said. In 1928, the top tax rate was 24%.
We're going to leave it there, guys. Guys, we're going to leave it there. It was great. Tomorrow, I'm joined by another great legendary astronaut, Buzz Aldrin, for NASA.